अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द पेरिडोंटल लिगामेंट। दिस इज़ द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द पेरिडोंटल लिगामेंट एंड दिस लेक्चर वुड कंक्लूड द पेरिडोंटियम। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी कवर्ड द ब्लड सप्लाई, द नर्व सप्लाई एंड द न्यूरल टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूरल एंडिंग्स ऑफ द पेरिडोंटल लिगामेंट। दैट कंक्लूडेड द composition of the periodontal ligament. The periodontal ligament is 100% soft connective tissue which has no mineral. It consisted of gram substance composed of water and gags and other non-collagenous matrix proteins onto which the fiber bundles of collagen fiber were embedded in the form of principal fibers. Then we had the elastic fibers, the reticulin and the oxytalin fibers, and then we had the cellular community in the form of synthetic resorptive cells, epithelial cells, defense cells and stem cells. Now we're going to talk about the functions of periodontal ligament. Periodontal ligament basically has supportive, sensory, physical, eruptive, nutritive and hemostatic functions. We're going to individually talk about all of these functions of the periodontal ligament. In terms of being supportive, the periodontal ligament basically supports the tooth in the socket. And while supporting that tooth in the socket, it at the same time permits the tooth to withstand considerable amounts of stresses that are put on the tooth in the form of masticatory forces. So it is supporting the tooth in the socket. How is it supporting it? It is letting the tooth stay in the socket, and at the same time it is letting the tooth permit to withstand the masticatory forces that are put on it. When basically a tooth moves in the socket that it is embedded, as a result of the forces acting on the tooth, chahe wo masticatory forces ho, chahe wo therapeutic forces in the form of orthodontic forces, what happens is whenever a force is put onto the periodontal ligament, a part of the periodontal ligament under the stress of that force will be narrowed. So jahan par basically force padi hoti hai, that part of the periodontal ligament gets narrowed, and in that part the periodontal ligament is compressed, whereas the other parts of the periodontal ligament at the same time widen to compensate for that compressed or narrowed area. So the compressed ligament basically provides support for the loaded teeth. And at the same time, the collagen fibers within the periodontal ligament, along with the water composition of the periodontal ligament, it acts as a cushion for the displaced tooth. So whenever a force is put on a tooth, that force, whether it is a masticatory force or an orthodontic force, that force is dissipated to the periodontal ligament. And when that force is dissipated to the periodontal ligament, because periodontal ligament has a supportive function, it compresses or narrows in that particular region. Or uske jo opposite side wala periodontal ligament hota hai, usko compensate karne ke liye widen ho jata hai. In that particular region jahan pe force padi hoti hai, collagen fibrils along with the water molecules, they act as a cushion for the tooth under stress. And in that region the vessels also provide a hydraulic cushion for the support of the tooth. So this is how the periodontal ligament has a supportive function towards the movement of the teeth within the socket. So that is how the periodontal ligament basically behaves as a suspensory ligament. Usne socket ke andar tooth ko hold bhi kiya hai, suspend bhi kiya hai, aur saath mein wo uski halki si movement bhi allow karta hai. The load on the periodontal ligament, jaise ki I just mentioned that when a force is put on the tooth, whether it is masticatory force or a therapeutic force, that force is dissipated to the periodontal ligament, and the periodontal ligament dissipates that force further to the alveolar bone through its principal fibers. And what happens is when the load on the PDL is dissipated to the alveolar bone through these principal fiber bundles, which is placed in tension on release of the load, these fibers, they recoil and bring the tooth to its recovering or resting position. So when the load is put on the tooth, that load is transferred to the periodontal ligament. The periodontal ligament provides a cushion for that tooth under stress, and at the same time it dissipates or distributes the same load to the alveolar bone through the principal fibers. And the principal fibers in that region, they are stressed, they come under tension. And when the load is released, they recoil back to their resting position. So that is how the periodontal ligament is being supportive, and it is acting as a suspensory ligament towards the teeth in the socket. The second and very important function of the periodontal ligament is its sensory nature. Periodontal ligament basically has two sensory functions, proprioception and mechanoreception. Proprioception is basically the awareness of the proper positioning of the jaw. So basically the periodontal ligament, it allows the organism to detect the application of the delicate most forces that are put on it, and very slight displacement of the teeth. तो अगर कोई slightest possible movement भी tooth की हो और अगर कोई slightest possible force भी अगर tooth के ऊपर लगे तो that is detected by the sensory receptors within the periodontal ligament. And then the next important sensory function that the periodontal ligament has is the reception of touch and pressure, which is called mechanoreception. So the periodontal ligament basically can sense both these, touch and pressure. It protects both the supporting structures of the tooth and the substances of the crown from excessive masticatory forces. Zara sa tap bhi agar aap tooth pe kare na, to that is sensed. The tooth is not entirely a living organism. Why is it sensing the tap on the tooth or dab on the tooth or a touch on the tooth? That touch basically is actually sensed by the sensory receptors or mechanoreceptors within the periodontal ligament. So the periodontal ligament has a very important sensory function, jo ki aapki proper tooth jaw position enable karta hai, aur touch or pressure ki sensations ki reception allow karta hai. Then the periodontal ligament, it has a nutritive function. As we talked that the periodontal ligament basically has lots of blood vessels. These blood vessels provide the anabolites and other substances that are required by the cells of the ligament for their nutrition. So it has a nutritive function. At the same time, the blood vessels are all, these similar blood vessels are concerned with the removal of any sort of catabolites that has to be removed from the periodontal ligament. So kahin bhi किसी भी पार्ट ऑफ द पेरिडोंटल लिगामेंट के अंदर इफ देयर इज नेक्रोसिस और ऑक्लूजन ऑफ दीज ब्लड वेसल्स ड्यू टू एप्लीकेशन ऑफ एक्सेसिव और हैवी ऑर्थोडोंटिक फोर्स और थेरेप्यूटिक फोर्स ऑन टू द टूथ विथ एंड द लिगामेंट, उस रीजन से जब ब्लड वेसल्स occlude ho jati hain, so that particular region is necrosed of cells, because when the blood vessels are occluded, obviously the ligament cells do not get the proper nutrition, and that is why that particular region has to lose its cells, because they are not provided with the proper nutrition. So it has a very important nutritive function. Then the periodontal ligament basically also helps in the eruption of the tooth. It provides a space, and it basically acts as a medium for cellular remodeling of the alveolar bone and the cementum, and hence it helps in the eruption of the tooth and any sort of proximal shift that has to occur after the eruption. So by providing a space for the eruption and by providing a mechanism or medium for cellular remodeling, it helps in the continued eruption of the tooth. Then the periodontal ligament has a very important physical function in protecting the vessels and the nerves from mechanical forces. As I said that the tooth is constantly be under stress if a therapeutic force in the terms of orthodontic therapy is applied on them. So in that case, The periodontal ligament protects its blood vessels and nerves from these excessive mechanical forces. It offers resistance to impact from occlusal forces by transmitting the occlusal forces to the bone to attain the shock resorption. So what happens is when the force is applied on the tooth in terms of orthodontic force or masticatory force, that load is not restricted to the tooth. It is dissipated to the periodontal ligament, and the periodontal ligament further dissipates it to the adjacent bone. तो इस तरह से ये बेसिकली shock resorption कर रहा होता है आपका periodontal ligament. So in doing this, it is protecting itself and the tooth from any sort of damage. Then the periodontal ligament has a very important hemostatic function. How does it provide hemostasis? Hemostasis is a साइंटिफिक टर्म और आई एम श्योर आपको इसका मतलब पता होगा. अगर किसी को इसका मतलब नहीं पता तो प्लीज़ गो ओपन अप गूगल एंड रीड इट आउट, बिकॉज आई थिंक मैंने तो फर्स्ट टाइम हीमोस्टेसिस FSC में शायद या OA लेवल्स में पढ़ा होगा. सो बेसिकली द सेल्स ऑफ द पेरिडोंटल लिगामेंट हैव द एबिलिटी टू रिजॉर्ब एंड सिंथेसाइज द एक्स्ट्रासेलुलर सब्सटेंसेस ऑफ द कनेक्टिव टिश्यू ऑफ द लिगामेंट, एल्वियोलर बोन एंड द सेमेंटम. सो द पेरिडोंटल लिगामेंट एट ऑल टाइम्स मेंटेन्स अ बैलेंस. इट रिजॉर्ब्स, इट सिंथेसाइजेस द एक्स्ट्रासेलुलर सब्सटेंसेस ऑफ द कनेक्टिव टिश्यू एंड इट रिजॉर्ब्स देम. सो there is a very delicate balance between this synthesis and resorption. So the periodontal ligament at all times maintains that balance, and that balance maintenance basically is called hemostasis. The alveolar bone is resorbed and replaced at a very higher rate than any other tissue in the jaw. And the collagen fiber of the periodontal ligament is also turned over at a very fast rate as compared. In fact, it has the fastest turnover rate than any connective tissue of the body. Whereas the bone has half the turnover rate as compared to the ligament. And the cementum comes third in that sequence. So the periodontal ligament has the highest turnover rate of the collagen, then has the alveolar bone, and then has the cementum. So this is how the periodontal ligament maintains its six functions, which are supportive, nutritive, eruptive, physical, hemostatic, and sensory. ठीक है. Now we are going to talk about how the periodontal ligament maintains this hemostasis. Periodontal ligament basically has a remarkable capacity, as I said, of maintaining a balance between its newly formed cells and the old cells. So the synthetic capacity and the resorptive capacity of the periodontal ligament is very delicately and closely monitored. It also has a very remarkable capacity. Because of this remarkable capacity of maintaining the balance between resorptive and synthetic activity, PDL is able to maintain its width more or less over time. And this is a very important fact, because the periodontal ligament is a soft tissue present between two hard tissues. Actually, on one side it has cementum and on the other side it has the alveolar bone. So technically PDL in cases of the pathological conditions, the PDL could sometimes get mineralized. And if the PDL gets mineralized in pathological conditions, in that conditions the bone would fuse to the alveolar to the root of the tooth, resulting in the ankylosis, fusion of the root with the bone, and mineralization of the periodontal ligament results in the ankylosis of the tooth. So basically, which is not a normal thing, it is a pathological condition. Under normal circumstances, the periodontal ligament has this remarkable capacity of maintaining its width and staying unmineralized. Basically, the populations of cells within the periodontal ligament, both during its development and regeneration, they secrete certain molecules that have the capacity to regulate the extent of mineralization of the periodontal ligament. These molecules basically prevent the fusion of the tooth root with the surrounding bone. And these molecules basically prevent the mineralization of the ligaments of the periodontal space. And these molecules include prostaglandins, MSX, bone CLO proteins, matrix GLA proteins. Out of these proteins, MSX basically prevents the osteogenic differentiation of the periodontal ligament fibroblasts. This is expressed by the this happens by repressing the RUNX2 activity. So what happens is that the cells within the periodontal ligament, they secrete certain molecules like MSX that prevents the PDL fibroblasts from differentiating and synthesizing the mineral, and that is how they prevent the mineralization of the periodontal ligament. Then we have the prostaglandins that inhibit the mineralization of the bone tissue, that basically inhibit the mineralized bone tissue. Then we have matrix GLA proteins, which are also inhibitors of mineralization. So the cells within the cellular community within the PDL, it secretes these molecules like prostaglandins, GLA proteins, which prevent the mineralization, and hence they let the periodontal ligament stay unmineralized and maintain its width over time. Then the PDL also has a very great capacity of adapting to functional changes. What does it mean? When the functional load or the demand on the periodontal ligament increases, the periodontal ligament adapts to that functional change by increasing its width, and it could increase its width in case of an increased demand by as much as 50%, which is quite a lot. And that increase in the width is because of the increase in the number and thickness of the fiber bundles. So when the functional demand on the PDL is increased, the periodontal ligament increases in width, and the number of collagen fiber or fiber bundles within the periodontal ligament increase by about 50%. Their thickness and their number increases. Whereas, as opposed to increased function, when the functional demand on the PDL decreases, the periodontal ligament, when it is not being used, it narrows, the space narrows. And in that case, the number of the fiber bundles and their thickness basically decreases. But it never happens that the PDL space goes out of existence unless there is a pathological condition. When the load on the periodontal ligament or the functional demand is high, not just the periodontal ligament widens or increases in thickness, the alveolar bone also increases in thickness. So in this figure, you can clearly see the difference in cross section of the periodontal ligament and the alveolar bone. The figure A, this one here, let me get a highlighter. Okay, this figure here shows the increased functional demand on the PDL, and this one here shows the decreased functional demand. So when the functional demand is high, not just the alveolar bone thickens, but the periodontal ligament space also widens. When the functional load is low, can you appreciate the change in the thickness of the alveolar bone? The alveolar bone narrows, and so does the periodontal ligament space. So that is how the periodontal ligament has the ability to respond or to adapt to the functional changes that are put on it. Then we are going to talk about the developmental of the periodontal ligament. as we know that periodontal ligament basically is present on the outside of the root, or basically the space between the root of the tooth and the bone is occupied by the ligament space. So the development of the periodontal ligament depends or begins with the formation of the root, and it happens prior to tooth eruption. Periodontal ligament, as we all know, develops from the dental follicle. So the dental follicle, basically the cells of the dental follicle that are located between the alveolar bone and the Hertwig epithelial root sheath, this population of cell gives rise to the periodontal ligament, and we divide these cells into two subpopulation: mesenchymal cells of the dental follicle proper and the perifollicular mesenchyme. So here in this figure you can clearly appreciate these two colonies. We have the perifollicular mesenchymal cells here and the mesenchymal cells of the dental follicle proper. So we have the dental follicle proper on the inside. This one is the dental follicle proper. These two population of cells between this Hertwig epithelial root sheath and the alveolar bone, between it, these two populations of cells, they give rise to the periodontal ligament cells. The perifollicular cells are bounded by the mesenchymal cells of the dental follicle. दोनों sides पे dental follicle proper होता है, दरमियान में mesenchymal cells होते हैं. As the root formation continues, the cells in the follicular proper and the perifollicular region, they gain polarity and their volume increases. Which volume? The cellular volume, basically. The protein synthesizing organelles increase in number, basically. So when the formation continues, the dental follicular cells in the perifollicular and the follicular proper region, they gain polarity. They start producing, they start having high cellular volume and increased protein synthesizing organelles, increased number of protein synthesizing organelles. These cells eventually obtain a long, thin, elongated cytoplasm with an increased amount of protein synthesizing organelles like mitochondria, Golgi apparatus, rough endoplasmic reticulum, and all of that. Why? Because these cells now have to actively secrete the periodontal ligament. As a result, these cells actively synthesize and deposit the collagen fibrils of the periodontal ligament, which is type 1 collagen mostly. And along with secreting the collagen fibrils, they also secrete the non-collagenous proteins into which the collagen fibrils basically embed. And all of this is being secreted in the developing region of the periodontal ligament. Sorry. The developing and mature periodontal ligament contains undifferentiated stem cells, as we know. And these cells basically are those cells that always retain the potential to differentiate into any type of synthetic cell, an osteoblast, cementoblast, or fibroblast, depending upon the stimulus. These stem cells adopt a perivascular location, as we know, in the ligament close to the bone lining or close to the alveolar bone side, which is called the endosteal space. So for the formation of the periodontal ligament, where are the cells coming from? They're coming from the dental follicle. Which part of the dental follicle? The follicle proper and the perifollicular region. और ये साथ साथ कब हो रहा होता है? जैसे जैसे root formation हो रही होती है, साथ साथ periodontal ligament भी develop कर रहा होता है. And as the root formation continues, the cells in this region, they gain polarity and eventually they become long elongated cells with a high amount of protein synthesizing organelles, and then they start secreting collagen fibers and the non-collagenous matrix proteins of the periodontal ligament. Side by side, as we said that the cells are secreting the collagen fibrils, these collagen fibrils, what are they? They eventually form the principal fiber bundles that are the main component of the periodontal ligament. So immediately before tooth eruption and sometimes after the tooth eruption, active fibroblasts adjacent to the cementum side of the coronal one-third of the root, they align in an oblique direction to the long axis of the tooth. And soon after the first collagen fiber bundles of the ligament, they become recognizable or discernible. And these fiber bundles basically are the alveolar crest fiber bundle group. After that, similar fibers are observed on the adjacent bone surface of the developing alveolar bone. So what happens is that immediately before tooth eruption, these collagen fiber bundles, they are actively being secreted both on the cementum side and the alveolar bone side. These collagen fiber bundles from the cementum side and the alveolar bone side, they keep growing and they keep growing towards each other, and eventually in the center of the periodontal ligament they unite with each other, forming one principal fiber bundle extending from the alveolar bone to the cementum and maintaining the ligament that basically connects the tooth with the bone. So is tarah principal fiber bundle basically attachment provide karta hai for the tooth. तो किस तरह होता है बेसिकली कोलेजन फाइबर से किस तरह सिक्रीट हो रहे होते हैं? ऑब्वियसली फिब्रोब्लास्ट सिक्रीट कर रहे होते हैं. फिब्रोब्लास्ट दे आर सिक्रीटिंग कोलेजन ऑन द सीमेंटम साइड ऑफ द पेरिडोंटल लिगामेंट एंड एट द सेम टाइम दे आर ऑल्सो सिक्रीटिंग द कोलेजन फाइबर्स ऑन द bone side of the periodontal ligament. And these two collagen fibers from the cementum side and the bone side, they continue to elongate toward each other, intertwining, fusing, cross-linking with the individual collagen molecules, and eventually they unite across in the middle of the periodontal space, securing the attachment of the tooth to the bone. So if I draw this whole process here on the slide, आपको कैसा नजर आएगा? लेट मी शो यू. सो फ्रॉम द बोन साइड एंड द सीमेंटल साइड द कोलेजन फाइबर्स ग्रो. इसको मैं बी मार्क कर देती हूँ. इफ दिस इज द बोन साइड एंड दिस इज द सीमेंटल साइड, आई एम मार्किंग इट सी. सो फ्रॉम द सीमेंटल साइड द कोलेजन फाइबर द फिब्रोब्लास्ट दे सिक्रीट कोलेजन फाइबर्स हेयर एंड दे की दे स्टार्ट सिक्रीटिंग कोलेजन फाइबर्स ऑन द बोन साइड एज वेल एंड इवेंचुअली दीज फाइबर्स दे ग्रो टूवर्ड्स ईच अदर एंड दे मीट इन द सेंटर, मेकिंग अ कॉन्टिन्यूस प्रिंसिपल फाइबर बंडल सिक्योरिंग द अटैचमेंट ऑफ द टूथ टू द बोन. एंड बाय द टाइम द टूथ comes into its final occlusal position and it touches its opposite tooth in the oral cavity, the principal fiber bundles around coronal 1/3 of the root as horizontal fiber horizontal group has almost completely developed. So by the time the tooth comes into its active occlusal position, all of the horizontal group has developed. However, oblique fibers in the middle third of the root are still being formed, because by the time the tooth erupts, the root has just formed till the middle third. The apical region has not yet formed. So the apical fiber group bundles develops after definitely the root apex has formed. तो इस तरह ये parts के अंदर develop करता है as the tooth continues to erupt. So what happens is, before the tooth has erupted, the crest of the alveolar bone basically is located above the cemento-enamel junction, and at that time the periodontal ligament fiber bundles within the periodontal ligament are obliquely directed, and these fibers, the fibers that are first to develop within the periodontal ligament are the alveolar crest fiber bundles. ठीक है? So as you can see in this figure A, this tooth has not yet erupted completely. When the tooth has not yet erupted, the alveolar bone or the alveolar crest is above the cemento-enamel junction. This is where your cemento-enamel junction is, and this is where, let me change the color of this highlighter, it's not very prominent. Okay, So before eruption, the alveolar crest is higher than the cemento enamel junction. This is your cemento enamel junction and this is your alveolar crest. At this time, the alveolar crest is located above the cemento enamel junction, and at this time, the alveolar crest fiber bundles are obliquely oriented, as you can see here. And they have an opposite arrangement as compared to what is needed, what actually alveolar crest group has. Actually, alveolar crest group has this arrangement. This is how the alveolar crest fibers are arranged. But right now, this is the arrangement. Okay, this is the attachment. They are oblique, but they have a higher attachment or coronal attachment on the bone and a cervical attachment or basically apical attachment on the cementum. इन्होंने अब उल्टा होना है, वो उनकी एक्चुअल पोजिशन है. सो व्हेन द टूथ स्टार्ट्स मूविंग इन द ओरल कैविटी, एज यू कैन सी अभी एरप्ट होना शुरू हो गया, पहले ये देखो बिल्कुल एम्बेडेड था. व्हेन द टूथ स्टार्ट्स मूविंग, दीज फाइबर्स इवेंचुअली दे बिकम ऑब्लीक एंड देन दे बिकम हॉरिजॉन्टल. एंड व्हेन द टूथ कम्स इनटू एक्टिव ऑक्लूजन, एज व्हेन द सीईजे इज at the level of the alveolar bone or slightly above it, that is the final position or final functional position of your tooth. Before that, while the tooth is moving, when the alveolar bone coincides, basically the alveolar bone and the CEJ, when they come on the same level, these oblique fibers, these oblique horizontal fibers, they become horizontal. And when the tooth comes into active occlusion, that is when the alveolar crest is below the CEJ, then these alveolar crest group again become oblique, such that they have a lower or the apical attachment on the bone and higher or cervical attachment or coronal attachment on the CEJ. तो ये इस अटैचमेंट से इवेंचुअली इस अटैचमेंट तक आने के लिए the tooth eruption is helping it. So before the tooth erupts, the alveolar crest group alveolar crest is located below the CEJ, and the PDL fiber bundles are obliquely directed such that they have a higher attachment on the bone and the lower attachment on the cementum. While the tooth moves during eruption, the crest of the alveolar bone eventually coincides here in this figure C. You can see the alveolar crest being at the same level of the CEJ. At that time, these fiber bundles, they become horizontally aligned. As you can see, they are horizontally aligned. And eventually, when the tooth comes into functional position, as you can see in the figure D, these horizontal fibers, which are actually the alveolar crest fibers, they become oblique again, now with the cementum attachment above and the alveolar bone attachment below, okay, which is the actual position of these horizontal or the alveolar crest group. By this time, we have lots of oblique fiber, almost half of the oblique fiber groups developed till the middle of the root. And as you can see, the apex of the root has not yet developed. And the apical fiber groups do not develop, obviously, until the apex of the root has developed. And at the same time, you can see the horizontal group also has developed. So this is how the periodontal ligament develops. The periodontal ligament is developing from the dental follicular cells, and it depends upon the root formation and the eruption of the tooth for its formation. When the root formation begins, the follicular cells of the dental follicle, they differentiate into fibroblasts, and that actively starts secreting the collagen fibers and the non-collagenous matrix proteins both on the cemental side and the alveolar side of the periodontal ligament. And these collagen fibers, they continue to grow towards each other until they meet in the center of the periodontal ligament space, and we get a continuous attachment of the bone and the cementum, and that is how your tooth is attached. And this is how all of these ligament or fiber bundles of the periodontal ligament develop. The eruption of the tooth is also helping the ligaments of the fiber bundles of the periodontal ligament attaining the eruption of the tooth basically is helping attaining these fibers or the fiber bundles their eventual or final position along with the eruption of the tooth. So by the time the tooth comes into functional occlusion, the alveolar crest group has completely developed, the horizontal fiber group has completely developed, and some of the oblique fibers have developed until the middle of the root, and the alveolar the apical fiber has not developed, because when the tooth erupts, by that time the root formation has not yet been completed. So when the apex of the root develops, only then does the development of the periodontal ligament fiber bundles completes. So this is all about the development of the PDL and the function of the periodontal ligament. This here concludes the periodontal ligament and the periodontium. The question and answer session for this lecture is going to be on the 16th, which is Tuesday, 11 o'clock, inshallah. I will see you guys then. Allah Hafiz.